It's the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for Saturday, the 10th of March. I'm Michael Graff. Moisture on the increase today and maybe some rain coming in here by this afternoon and tonight, lingering possibly into tomorrow. Just how much rain we get and what about the week ahead? Are we still looking at an unsettled weather pattern for late in the week? Well, let's get out there and talk about it this morning as we look at the almanac from yesterday. 84 degrees, the high in the valley yesterday after a morning low of 54. And outside right now here at 11:30 a.m., we are under mostly cloudy skies. 72 degrees at Sky Harbor, dew points at 32. Humidity 20%, the winds are light, and the barometer is steady. Temperatures across south central Arizona this morning, just about all of us are in the 70s at this hour under mostly cloudy to cloudy skies. Water vapor satellite view, a little short wave, a very weak ripple in the atmosphere coming across the area with a mainly zonal flow. Quite a bit of Pacific moisture on the increase though. And we're starting to see some rain develop over western Arizona. This looks a little bit more daunting than it actually is. This is very light rain falling from Yuma all the way up toward Kingman. And the rain is about as close now as western Maricopa County. So we'll start to see some light sprinkles or light showers developing later this afternoon. More details on that momentarily. Watch warning maps and red flag advisories extend from parts of West Texas through New Mexico and Colorado. A few winter weather advisories and wind advisories in parts of the Dakotas. And on the convective outlook, a slight risk of severe storms today from around Fort Smith, Arkansas, south and east toward Jackson, Mississippi. A marginal risk for some of the adjacent states, the lower Mississippi River Valley. And precipitation around here for the next 7 days. This is valid through next Saturday morning, showing anywhere from around 1/4 to 1/2 inch here in the valley. Heavier totals across northern Arizona, coastal southern California, up through parts of Nevada. Could see some pretty heavy rain and mountain snows. And we'll get into the details of that right now as we check the models and see what's going on. This is the GFS. It's the 12Z run, valid at 5 o'clock this afternoon at 500 millibars. A little weak wave coming through. There's our mainly zonal flow down at the surface. Cloudy skies today. High temperatures getting into the mid and upper 70s. I don't think we're going to get to 80, but maybe a few of the warmest desert spots get close. And scattered light showers developing this afternoon. The key word here is light. Not going to see an overly heavy rainfall from this, but certainly more so than initially thought. I think the heaviest totals, of course, be across the favored upslope areas of central and northern Arizona and, of course, coastal southern California. Here's the high-resolution NAM, the 3-kilometer NAM this afternoon at 3 o'clock. It's got some widespread light rain coming down across southern Arizona. Pretty good chance that a lot of us get wet today, but again, this is not going to be a flooding or soaking rain, but do keep this in mind if you have outdoor activities this afternoon. Tonight at 10 o'clock off the NAM, the rain continues. It's starting to push off to the east at this point, and by tomorrow morning, most of that starts to taper off. As for tomorrow, mostly cloudy skies continue. We'll start the day off probably in the mid-50s to around 60 degrees. We'll climb back into the low and mid-70s with mostly cloudy skies. We'll see some sun coming out by tomorrow, though, especially during the afternoon hours. This is the SREF plume. These are the short-range ensemble forecasts, and you can see the mean is the dark line there, showing about a tenth of an inch of rain for us here in the valley. Some of the higher totals pushing up toward a third of an inch. I don't think we're going to see that kind of precipitation, but around a tenth of an inch, certainly possible. My suspicion is that most of us will probably just see a trace to a few hundredths of an inch. This is not going to be a big storm by any means. Monday, ridging comes back into the southwest, but that doesn't mean the clouds are all gone. We'll call it partly cloudy with high temperatures mostly mid and upper 70s, upper 70s to low 80s on Tuesday with partly cloudy skies. Bit more cloud cover coming in by Wednesday as troughing continues to dig off the west coast. High temperatures still upper 70s to about 80. Thursday, mid and upper 70s with mostly cloudy skies coming in at this point. Maybe an isolated shower or two by late in the afternoon or the evening coming into the western part of the state. But the GFS is slowing down the progression of this trough and the evolution of the low pressure area to our west. And so what we thought was going to be a very wet day on Friday may be delayed slightly, at least toward the afternoon hours. But there's a lot of room for change. A lot can change between now and then. The models still not showing complete run-to-run consistency with the idea of this system coming in here by late in the week. For now, looks like a chance of showers coming in by the afternoon. Then a week from today, this is Saturday the 17th, St. Patrick's Day. Could be a wet one with unsettled weather here in the Southwest and cooler too. Highs Friday and Saturday could be down into the mid and upper 60s, maybe even cooler than that depending on rainfall. And then Sunday, this is the 18th, still looking with at below average heights and unsettled weather here across the Southwest, partly to mostly cloudy skies and maybe a slight chance of showers. And then the end of the forecast period, this is Monday the 19th, deep low pressure off the West Coast, Southwest flow here. The clouds continue at this point. It looks dry, but we've seen all sorts of different ideas out here, different solutions out toward 10 days. So the bottom line is you just have to keep watching and see what happens. Check the numbers coming off the GFS ensemble through the period. Yeah, above average temperatures, a little bit cooler tomorrow, but for the most part, above average for the first half of the upcoming week. Then we really cool it off by next weekend. Highs could certainly be down in the 60s, maybe a little bit cooler than what's shown here, and those overnight lows coming down as well as unsettled weather appears likely. And that's going to wrap it up for the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for today. My next video comes back here tomorrow morning. And if you like our videos, be sure to subscribe so that whenever we post a brand new one, you'll get the notifications. Otherwise, be safe out there. Have yourselves a great Saturday.